Here I was, some hopped-up gringo a long way from home, making trouble the only way I knew. As the weather worsened, I caught a glimpse of the rusted shells of previous lives that had been lived out here in this swampy shithole, and I wondered if I would end up the same way, or what would happen to that girl I was supposed to protect. I had no idea what lay ahead, and as much as part of me would rather be anywhere else, I knew this was where I had to be. I felt responsible. I just had to fix the situation, right here. I couldn't understand them, but I didn't have to. Cheap hoods are the same from here to Timbuktu. The slab of meat on the boat was clearly the boss. Serrano, they called him. And it seemed that our suspicions were correct. Fabiana was here, somewhere further ahead. I had to find her quickly and quietly if possible. Last thing I wanted was a party with these clowns.
Foda!
I guessed the center of the maze was in this direction. I kept moving toward the signs of life, rubbing them out as I went along. I'd seen enough to know that Fabiana was at least alive, if not exactly well. Her captors didn't look like they were quite the kind and gentle type. I had to find that room quickly.
Vai se fuder, cara!
Vai tomar no meio do cu!
Eu vou te meter bala, hein?
Vai se fuder, porra!
Oi! Dani! Você tá aí? Você tem um cigarro?
I didn't want to think about what would be happening on that video feed now. Just my own imminent cameo. The room I'd seen was somewhere up ahead. They probably made their ransom notes from the same glossy magazines they used to select their victims. This was a second request for payment. The best of intentions at the stadium weren't enough to cover it. My blood was boiling. I didn't have time to wallow in guilt and misery. Just shoot and move. I had to keep moving. I hoped that I'd find Fabiana sooner than later, if at all. That was the chair that she had been held in. I had just missed them.
A dor. Com a idade vem a dor. É dor de cabeça, dor de estômago, dor na virilha, dor nas juntas, dor de ressaca. É por isso que existe Interfectum. Interfectum é um analgésico forte para a dor forte.
This is INC.
We have reports of more violence erupting in Panama, where citizens are still reeling from this attack 2 months ago. Colombian paramilitary group United Souls of the People, or AUP, have been waging a campaign of violence and terror in the area around Bastidas, despite government attempts to stabilize the region. Staying in Latin America, an explosion of violence in Brazil's largest city, Sao Paulo, as much publicized initiatives to stop feuding between favela gangs and the police have completely failed. Some local activists blame much of the city's problems on the activities of right-wing groups Cracha Preto and Nova Garda, who they accuse of vigilante-style attacks in the areas of the city where police have lost control. Some human rights organizations report a slew of missing persons in the city, a topic that many observers say local law enforcement isn't taking seriously. This turmoil is shaping up to be a hot topic in next year's mayoral election. Right-wing candidate Victor Bronco was once a frontrunner, but is now falling behind in the polls. Well, there may be some political storm clouds out there, but the sun is shining in many regions today. Over to Marisol with the weather.
Here we go again. She was on the move. If they'd finally decided to kill her, I wasn't doing anything to persuade them otherwise.
Burguesinha, safado! Vou te pegar, é? Vou te pegar antes que eu boto uma bala na tua cabeça.
There she was, right in front of me. The drunk fool in me wanted to make a play.
Puta! Vamos!
But I had just about enough sense to know that I'd end up with another dead girl in my arms if I did.
Não, velho, não. O irmão já falou, velho. Eu não quero dela inteira. Aí,
thank you.
It seemed Serrano's boys had targeted the entire Bronco family and didn't give a shit which one they pinched. Serrano had taken Fabiana through the garage door. I had to find a way to open it. Coke in the air wasn't doing anything to sharpen my thinking. Was there a switch in that room? I opened the door to the next circle of this low-rent hell. I could get through on the catwalk if I went back into the other room.
Let's go.
seen Fabiana in a worrying amount of time, but at least I wasn't following a trail of her fingers. I had to keep on going across the docks. They had to be out there. I needed to trigger the walkway. There they were. I had the feeling I'd been running one step behind ever since I got to this country. Maybe a few years before that as well.
Fabiana.
They took her in a boat. That way. Straight ahead.
Okay, okay, don't worry. Hang on.
Boy, did I need to hang on. The whole operation was slipping out of our grip. I was an overconfident jungle going into the jungle alone.
Shit, more company!
Star, she's alive?
How much longer? I don't know.
She's not gonna take much more of this!
Decoy boat!
Shit! Grenade! Grenade!
Down!
That doesn't look so good.
I think she's flooded, bro! I gotta try and get her back out!
Come on, let's go, brother.
Damn it! had an idea. Hold on. This shit's gonna come down to more than willpower.
Fabiana had slipped through my fingers for a second time. Another habit I didn't want or need.
It was close. We almost had her. Damn.
I don't think we ever had much of a chance. No one told us they had an entire goddamn army.
I don't think anybody knew. Crazy shit.
Yeah. It's all crazy, pal. Non-stop insanity. Thought I left all this shit behind. Easy gig, you said. What a fool I was to get involved in this madness.
Thank you.
you big bastard. Come on.
I'm up.
Yeah? You don't look up.
Just give me a second, will you? Really not feeling too good.
Hey, Max, what is it with you in interior design? Huh? You really know how to give a place a great lived-in feel, huh? This is beautiful.
Fuck off with the fucking wisecracks. Really, I'm not in the mood.
Okay, sorry, bro. The boss wants to see us, so let's go, come on. Take your time, man. Fucking unbelievable. Jesus.
I heard that.
Oh, give me a second. I'm not feeling so good.
Bom dia.
Ela estava aí?
O que o senhor acha? Claro que sim. E o senhor bem pontual,
tudo bem.
Não?
Ah. You fucking pair of clowns! I'm sorry, sir. We risked our lives several times over trying to save.
I know. I just wish I knew what was happening and why.
Yes. Who has it in for our family?
I mean, just because we are rich and happy, is that a good reason to hate us? I do a lot of good in this town. A lot.
This is hell for me. As I told you yesterday, when I get Fabiana back, I think I will move us to Miami or Geneva. It feels like nothing good can come from living in Sao Paulo right now.
I hope you're not giving up on our city, Senor Branco. Listen, we will catch the man. You have my word on that.
Listen to Mr. Becker, brother. Yes, these are tough times, but we have been through it before. Like when father died.
Father had a heart attack visiting a brothel. Yeah, it was humiliating and embarrassing for sure. But now this is different. This is the Emperor.
Well, she's not dead. Maybe we'll be lucky and get her back safe soon.
I can almost guarantee it, if you do as I ask.
Maybe.
Be strong, brother. For your wife. I know this has been tough on you. But things will get better. For all of us. Hmm? Marcelo, pasos in my helicopter. This way.
Sure.
Mr. Becker?
Senor?
Let us give you a ride.
Bom. Até logo, Senor Branco. And may I say, you would be best served se contratar profissionais e não esses amadores pés de chinelo.
Goodbye, Mr. Becker.
Até logo, Senor Branco.
So many plans, Max.
Didn't we all?
I was born into great fortune. Sometimes it feels like I have done nothing apart from being a rich man in a poor country. The men I talk to, they only see money. Now my wife. I am not naive. She does not love me for my body.
Well, despite your good fortune, you're still a decent man.
Am I? I don't know. I try to be. But maybe I'm just another rich fool, just like the rest of my friends.
Com licença. Tenho uma ligação para o senhor, um policial chamado Senhor da Silva.
Ah, diga que eu ligo mais tarde.
Sim.
Another bent cop wanting a pension contribution. Do you think a pile of shit feels popular because it's surrounded by flies? Look at me. I'm a mess.
O que está acontecendo? Meu Deus! Sim, pode entrar!
Senhor, temos problema. O sistema de segurança foi desativado.
I can see that!
We got men entering the building, and the office won't lock down.
Posso?
Claro que pode.
It's not working. There's a way to reboot the system. If I can get to the server room, I should be able to get everything back online.
Strange. You pay a couple million dollars and you expect to push a button to be able to make all your problems go away. My God, was some useless junk and a bit of false confidence. I'm done, Max.
Sir, let us handle this. You stay in your office, lock yourself in. Do not answer the door unless you know it's me. Let's go.
I should be able to override the system if I could just get to the server room.
What's going on?
Nothing to worry about. Everything's fine. Get down behind the desk now, both of you.
Martin? Max! Max!
Yeah, it's safe. Come on.
We need to get you to the server room. Let's go.
Por que não posso ficar aqui com você debaixo da mesa?
Let's go. Come on.
Okay. I'm coming. Come on.
The real security guards had been run off, paid off, or bumped off. That left us. It wasn't a fantastically comforting thought.
Hey, Max!
This is the way!
This code should get us into the boardroom. Okay.
Glad to see the security system is keeping the right people out.
Ah! Oh shit!
What the hell?
We're going to see now! It's through here!
It was a lot shinier than a favela, and rent'd be easier to collect. Maybe Bronco would take pity on all the poor bastards who got evicted. I just had to keep him alive to find out. These clowns were the same guns for hire who jumped our exchange at the stadium. Cracha Prado, the Black Badge, right-wing paramilitary chumps protecting whoever paid the most. I guess that made them more like me than I cared to admit. Were they just looking for another payday, or did their business with the Broncos run deeper?
Eu vou por aqui, você vai por ali.
Demorou.
Silêncio!
Let's get that server back online.
Can we just spend a few more minutes? Make sure they're all gone?
Come on, don't worry. I got your back. Poor kid was scared shitless. But I thought we'd seen the worst of it.
Okay. The server room is just down here.
You're doing good. Come on.
Hey? I didn't think I'd have a day like this.
when I wake up in the mornings.
Wish I could say the same thing. Mm-hmm. Fact was, I'd gotten used to protecting Bronco in the big bad world. We hadn't anticipated a siege situation here. Hadn't prepared for it. I couldn't tell the kid that. Something told me these guys didn't have security clearance.
Max, come to me!
Come on, move. You gonna be able to fix this or what?
In a few minutes, eh? I should be able to reboot the system, get all the components back online.
What about Bronco's office? That's all I care about.
He should be able to lock us down, eh? If this works.
Well, whatever you're doing, do it quick. I'm gonna make a sweep of the building and then get back to Rodrigo's. The security system was back online. Things might be a little tougher for our fan club from here on in. Seemed like breaching the perimeter had been no more difficult than strolling through the front gates. But hey, who needs a Trojan horse when the alarm is down and your standing army is a dame, a dork, and a drunk? Bronco's office overlooked the atrium. I could check in and make sure he hadn't checked out.
Guy's working on the security system now, sir.
It just came on.
Okay, good. Then lock yourself down. Stay put. Let us take care of these guys down here. Once they realize they can't get to you, they should back off.
Max, try not to completely destroy the place.
Let's just concentrate on staying alive. Sir!
There it went. He was tucked up safe. Now I needed to make it to the lobby to complete my sweep of the building, for what that was worth. They could replace these on Monday morning. Hmm, graduation shots of Rodrigo, Victor, and Marcelo, educated at rich kid finishing schools all over Europe. No wonder they have the common touch. Poor girl was dead. Shot through the head by some hero fighting the rich one lonely secretary at a time. Looked like we had seen the worst of it. The elevator would take me back up to Rodrigo's office where we could wait the rest of it out. I didn't know what the hell I was gonna find up there, but I sensed it wasn't gonna be a stripper bursting out of a cake.
Senor Branco! Senor Branco! I can't get through to him. Ever since the security door is triggered, he hasn't made a sound.
Rodrigo, it's Max. Open up. Can you hear me?
Eu já tentei.
Senor Bronco, open up. I'm gonna try to get in there from the roof. You find the security guard and get the hell out of here.
Yes.
I knew there was another way in upstairs for the helipad. The little luxury runaround that kept the rich looking down on the poor literally as well as metaphorically.
Rodrigo!
Of course, he was dead. Clean, one shot, a professional job. I began to look for clues. I couldn't get playback on one of the cameras, and it looked like the disc was missing. Someone in this building was trying to keep things low-key. But then why had everyone else come driving through the goddamn wall? Fabiana. Even if the man who employed me was dead, his wife was still out there. Maybe she could be saved. Maybe some good... Picking the photo from the broken fragments, something caught my eye. Blind luck, it meant the blast wasn't fatal. If I'd been out for any longer, the smoke would have gotten me. They'd be serving me up in a churrascaria at this rate. Perfect. If I wasn't immolated, I was gonna get crushed to death. Look at me. I've been contracted to protect two people. One was being held in some hole. The other was sitting at his desk with a bullet in his head. And the company that had its logo on my paycheck was melting on top of my head. There's no way one bomb could have done all this, unless the place was made of gasoline. This whole joint must have been rigged. Kid hadn't made it. Fuck. I had to make this corpse-looting coward pay. Getting his gun was more than just expediency. I was in no state to save his body from the flames. I hadn't saved him from the gunman either. I'm sorry, kid. It felt like I was burning from the inside out. I had to go.
Está tudo bem! Pode ir!
Podcast Bronco is falling apart quite literally. Despite his manners, I'd done him a favor. This didn't look like a room where Rodrigo closed multi-million dollar deals. It looked like a fiery hellhole. I always loved steak, but not so much I wanted to become one. Someone had ordered barbecued gringo, but I didn't have to serve it to them. The only way out was to use that filing cabinet. So much for a lazy Sunday afternoon. My next trick would be a high wire act with a fiery pit for a safety net. It was nice that no one was shooting at me for a change, but I'd take shot in the head over a slow roast on a spit any day of the goddamn week. Someone up ahead was hurt pretty bad. If he didn't die before I got to him, I might get some answers.
Hey! Why? Why Rodrigo Bronco? Why did you come to kill Rodrigo Bronco?
Came to kill you. Because what you did to us. You killed so many of us.
What reason did this poor bastard have to lie? He would be dead from shock or loss of blood in half an hour, even if I didn't leave him there to burn.
Where's Fabiana?
What?
Fabiana Bronco, where is she?
La Comando Sombra got her. Up the hill.
Then it was up the hill for me, I guess, where the gang held sway. I had to try to figure out who was using these angry paramilitary clowns as some kind of front to kill Rodrigo. Rodrigo Bronco was dead. Fabiana was held hostage. I had no idea who was behind any of this. I felt like a fool. I was a sweaty, gray-haired mess. This place was gonna kill me, too. I could see that now. I decided that I was gonna die sober, not drunk. At least then I would see who shot me. It was was time to take back control from whoever was out to get me. And if I didn't flush them out, at least my midlife crisis would confuse them enough so they did something stupid. It was the only hope I had. I knew I wasn't thinking straight. I'd been drinking and popping painkillers for years. I had a liver like a French goose and skin like red leather. Well, it wasn't perfect. In fact, it wasn't much good at all, but it was gonna have to do. At least I was facing in the right direction.
Hello.
Max, you're alive?
Of course I'm alive.
We did not know this. We are lost, Max. Our brother was everything to us.
I understand. Listen, I'm sorry about your loss, both of you. Rodrigo was a good man. I failed him, but I was tricked.
What happened, Max?
I don't know.
Some guys from the Crush of Prado came into the building downstairs, so while me and the security guard were dealing with them, an assassin must have come in and executed your brother. At least that's how I think it happened.
No, you killed him, Poha. You killed my brother.
What are you talking about? I understand you're upset, but please, why the hell would I do that?
To get his money, to take his money.
How am I getting his money, Marcelo? Please, think. I worked my ass off for your family. I saved your life twice or more. Right now, I'm going to get Fabiana.
Where is she? Where is Fabiana, eh?
She's in a place called Nova Esperanza.
How do you know this, Max?
One of the Crotch of Prado told me just before he died.
Please, bring our sister-in-law back to us, Max. Our family is being torn apart.
So I guess I was finally about to go and experience the other side of Sao Paulo firsthand. The bit people try to ignore. The unpleasant memory they try to obliterate with cocktails and helicopters and parties and lines of blow, like rich fools the world over. I was a day off the sauce for the first time in years and knew I was due a hangover sent direct from Mother Nature. I had no idea where the hell I was gonna go, so I decided to head straight for the street party that seemed to be raging. Either that or some other fool had gotten there before me and now was being ritually sacrificed. I've had better ideas. But then I've also had worse ones, like accepting this job in the first place.
E aí, gringo?
You lost, kid.
Eu me amarro nos States. Você precisa de ajuda, senhor?
Speak English?
Aham, falo sim, sem problema.
I need to know if you've ever seen this girl, Fabiana. Come here for a second, look at her.
I know lots of girls, sexy. Come on. This way.
Where are you going? Wait a minute. Down there?
É isso.
Jesus.
This way, come on.
At least I found myself a tour guide. The way I see it, there's two types of people. Those who spend their lives trying to build a future, and those who spend their lives trying to rebuild the past. For too long, I've been stuck in between. Hidden in the dark. What was I really doing walking in there with my bad haircut and ridiculous shirt? Was I there to make something right? Or was I just using a messed up situation to indulge myself? Grasping at some desperate delusion of control. Maybe the two went hand in hand more than I cared to admit. I had stumbled into some kind of street party. This was the kind of reality Americans paid top dollar to see. Slums had become tourist attractions, places where yuppies could gawk at the endless spirit of the poor from the inside of their bulletproof buses. I felt dumb and exposed. I missed the booze. Not that it mattered, sober or drunk, I was hardly undercover. I stood out in this place like a streetwalker in a monastery. Barracos e morros sem socorro num lugar sem esperança, nada sem luz que possa inspirar.
Continua andando, caralho! Que porra é essa que você tá fazendo aqui? Como que você sai entrando aqui assim? Anda, anda, vai pra lá!
What do you need, guys? What do you need?
O que você tá fazendo aqui? Eu tô te perguntando! Eu te chamei aqui, porra!
Easy, pal, easy!
Ah, então, você é americano de merda!
Look, I didn't mean any offense.
Me dá só uma razão pra eu não te matar, seu americano burro!
Desculpa, amigo, por favor.
Passa tudo que você tem, viado! Pega o dinheiro dele, pega o dinheiro dele! Ah, relojão, hein? Passa aqui. Anda logo! Anda logo! Filho da puta! Valeu, mano! Bem-vindo à favela Nova Esperança!
All things considered, I was gonna have to look on this as a good outcome. I was deep in gang territory. These kids were raised hating clowns like me. Middle-income ass-kickers who protected the rich by shooting kids like them. First day off the sauce, and somehow I'd still ended up in the gutter. If there was one thing I'd learned since I've been here, it was that Brazilians came out of the womb kicking a ball. And for kids like these, was their one legal chance at a ticket out of here.
Ah, look.
Mostra.
Pô, que isso, é a coisa mais simples. Vai lá, mostra pra ele. Você escolhe um dos...
Desculpa, olá. Fala inglês. I'm a little lost, perdido. Onde estou?
Tá no lugar errado, rapá.
Não compreende. I need a phone, a telephone.
Bora.
Público.
A gente não é centro de informação turística, não, Bim.
Well, they weren't gonna help me. And who could blame them? I was a dumb American in a place where dumb Americans were less popular than the clap. If I was gonna find my way out of this mess, I was on my own. It looked like there was a bar up ahead. The irony was not lost on me. I figured sobriety was no use to me dead.
Ah, passa o baseado. Ih, não é tua vez não. Passa aí, meu.
Aí, tem visto a irmã do Wilson, mano?
Ah, o que esse cara quer?
Aí, bela camisa, hein? Tu perdeu o fusão, amigo.
de cima de mim, meu.
This classy-looking establishment would have a phone so I could call Passos. Either that or a gun so I could shoot myself and save these kids the bother.
Hey, the telephone.
Telefone, vai, lá no fundo, segue em frente.
When you're stuck in a foreign country and you don't know the words for reverse charges, and you're in some lonely skin joint in the middle of some poor slum, having just had every last cent robbed from you, and you call yourself a bodyguard, then you know you're a loser.
Hey, Matt, can I buy you a beer?
Do I know you?
No, I don't think so.
Look, if you're gonna shoot me, make it quick, I'm a little busy.
If I was going to shoot you, I wouldn't waste a beer.
Wait, you won't try to dry out a bit. It's just a soda, please.
Sure. Why don't you go sit down?
Guaraná pra ele, um choque pra mim. Bem gelado.
Interesting haircut, by the way. Meant to tell you that.
Yeah, well.
Wilson da Silva. Very good to meet you.
Nice to meet you, I think.
Although you'll forgive me if I promise never to employ you as my bodyguard. You did a great job watching after Rodrigo Branco.
Fuck you.
You were set up.
Bet your ass I was.
Now, let me ask you something. Have you ever seen this guy? Serrano.
Yep. He's a real sweetheart.
Yeah, he sure put his gang out of business. But don't worry, those guys, they're a small fry. This is the guy I'm interested in. Neves. And this is his little buddy here. Milo Hegel. They work for this vigilante group. Crasha Preto.
Yep, I know him.
They're very popular with right-wing politicians, like Victor Branco. Now, you see, many years ago, he helped clear some villages on a bit of land Rodrigo Branco wanted to develop.
Rodrigo Branco?
Yes, he did some very bad things. Anyway, have you ever seen this guy?
Maybe at the stadium.
I knew you were involved in that business. You know, I wanted to investigate that, but I got an order to blame it on some local street kids instead. Tell me, what happened there?
Nothing. We simply went to hand over some cash to this guy's clowns for a ransom exchange when this guy's clowns jumped us and they shot everybody.
Apart from you and your boy Passos.
That's right. We had to shoot our way out of there.
They let you go. Okay, it's a little weird right now. But I know that Victor Branco is involved in all this. I just don't know how or why. And I know that the UFE are involved in all this as well, but I just don't know how or why. And you know what's gonna happen? The moment is gonna come along when I put all these pieces together, and at that moment, someone is gonna come along and put a bullet in my head. Anyway, listen. I think you might want this.
Thank you. I'll need it.
And if it's Fabiana Branco you've come looking for, I think she's up the hill.
So why don't you just go get her?
I don't know. Well, I'm a cop. I mean, I'll fight corruption. I'll stand up to the rich and dumb, but if I go up that hill right now, I'll be dead in 3 minutes or less. Maybe you too, Max. You're in the jungle now.
So it appears.
If you survive the next hour, let's speak. You help me. And I'm gonna do what I can to help you. Good luck!
I didn't know what to make of what this guy had just told me. What was true and what was just someone else's convenient bullshit. Then some less than friendly locals came in and found me in the wrong mood to party.
E aí, Green? O que você tá fazendo aí?
No comprende. Leave me alone.
Você tem alguma coisa pra mim?
Do you got something for me?
For you? I'll tell you what I got. I got a gun, and if anybody thinks they're gonna take it from me, they'd be dead wrong.
I'd have felt worse taking someone's medication if everybody in that place hadn't been trying to kill me. The show was over. It was time to get out of there.
No shooting! Por favor, amigo! No, no!
Relax, soldier.
You're American? Oh, jeez, buddy. Am I glad to see you? Oh, fuck me. I've been coming to this shithole town for the last 5 years. It's like a fucking insane asylum. But it's got the cheapest pussy in the world. But fuck me. I mean,
you're in a cat house in the slum, pal, doing who knows what.
I'm a businessman, bro. And they were fully legal. In this country, I think, and I know how to tip, all right? It ain't my fault, man. It ain't my fault. Don't judge me, all right?
Have a nice day. Jesus, what a fucking creep. It was Monday afternoon, and I'd already been thrown out of a party, gone to a strip club, and gotten to a bar fight. This latest midlife crisis was certainly ticking all the boxes.
Puta!
nenhuma. A gente desce ou não?
Foda-se! Isso aí já era, não vale a pena não.
Tá certo.
The fireworks display was clearly in my honor, making sure everyone knew to roll out the red carpet for their surprise guest.
Well, guys, I think this is where we will wrap things up. I had fun, and I'm hoping you did too. But yeah, we will resume this endeavor in the next entry. But until then, you guys take care of yourselves. Love, peace.